when we look around, does it seem that violence and murder has become the order of the day? We may deny it, but we should not be blind to the reality. We, the Sokosians, present before you the harsh realities evidently seen around us.
As the accused has confessed her crime and the prosecution could prove that all the evidences are against the accused, she deserves the punishment. The court analyzes that the accused has murdered 6 members of her own family by poisoning them. And it is considered to be the rarest of rarest cases. Hence, the court orders that the accused should be hanged to death.
Welcome to the 1586th episode of Deshyanat. Today, we are going to discuss about the recent murder case in which the culprit has murdered 6 members of her own family. For that, I would like to invite the head of social department, Mr. Jagannath.
Thank you.
Welcome to the show, sir. Please be seated. Next, I invite the famous woman activist, Mrs. Ramadevi Varma.
Oh, thank you.
Welcome to the show, ma'am. Please be seated. And finally, I would like to invite the famous transgender activist, Natasha D'Souza. Welcome to the show. Please be seated. So, Mrs. Ramadevi Varma, what are your views on this murder case that has shaken the conscience of Kerala?
In my opinion, since she is a woman, she should be treated fairly. And if she had committed such a big crime, our society is responsible for this. Yes, our society made her do this. The sick mentality of this society, that the money, power and position are the greatest things in a man's life, should be changed. And we the women are struggling to get equality with men. And we deserve well.
No, you are just talking nonsense. Women should be under the control of men.
So, Mr. Jagannath, do you mean that women are the slaves of men?
Yes, exactly. Recently, I have written a book about how an ideal woman should be. Did anyone of you read it?
We don't read such rubbish journals. Excuse me, do you both mean that this society is only for men and women? We too deserve it.
Oh my God, this is not an election to share. It's a crime. Do you want that too?
See, what I mean is that we too deserve this society. When I analyze this serial killing, what I want to say is that this person is not mentally stable.
So, Natasha, do you mean that the culprit is innocent?
No, never. I don't mean to say that the culprit is innocent. But a mentally stable person cannot do all these things, okay?
Yeah, that's right. A person's mental health and behavior must all originate from his family. Here the problem, some male chauvinist pigs must know how to treat the woman
equally. Stop this nonsense. You are insulting me. Do you know who I am? I'm Jagannath.
Sir, please be seated. You are in front of the camera. This is a live program.
I don't care. It's a live show. Come out, I will show you.
We don't even want to see you. Just go, man.
Sir, please don't go, sir. Sir, please. Okay, so now let's continue with the show. So, Srimati Ramadevi Varma, you may please continue with your views.
According to my assumptions, the culprit's childhood must be very miserable. Or else she couldn't have mustered up this much courage.
Okay, since the time has come to an end, I would like to end today's episode. This is Shashi Mukhya Proy of Deshyanat, signing off. What? A mother killed her own son? What? Was she drunk? Oh, wow. Don't share this news to anybody else. I'm coming there. Yeah, bye.
Molly, may I know why you killed me? What was my mistake? Even though I was your mother-in-law, I loved you like my own child. I would have given you all my wealth if you would have asked me. But no, you killed everyone. You killed my son. You killed my husband. You killed an infant too, Molly. What did you gain, Molly, by doing this? What did you gain?
What's happening to me? Am I dreaming? My thoughts, my late realizations, all are haunting me. I'm getting mad.
Molly, what you did was right. Because if you want to live in this society, you needed money, power, and status. You did a good job, my girl. You did a good job. Molly, you should never hurt a person just for money. Ask your conscience. You should never justify your sin.
Don't listen to her. This whole world will never stand by your side. Take revenge to this world by killing yourself. Kill yourself. Never yield to the judgment and the punishment of the court. Kill yourself. Kill yourself.
Molly, no. You should never kill yourself. Confess your sins to God and ask for His mercy. Committing suicide means destroying the life given by God. You should never do it, my child. You should never do it.
Do you think that she can help you? Let me help you. Let me save you from
Molly,
this.
No, no, save your soul. Molly, save your soul. To me. I did the murder mercilessly, and I deserve the punishment too. To whom shall I confess and share my feelings? I did the crime to be the richest, or else I wouldn't be worthy in the society. How cruel I was. Yes, my convictions were totally wrong. If I had done according to my conscience, I could have changed my life. Now I lost everything, even my soul. God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Let no one repeat it. No one repeat it. God!
There is a wrong way or a right way. Molly chose the wrong way in her life. Murdering people for the sake of financial growth cannot be justified. Let's hope that neither Molly do not take birth in this world. Let's have dreams, but let our dreams follow the truth.